Hello everybody, this is Matt Landstand. Here we are again on Planet Coaster. And if you saw the last video, I'm recording this straight after. Absolutely straight after. I've never noticed that growing on the roof before. That's pretty cool. I like that. I like how it overhangs there as well. Ah, that's pretty nice. Right, yeah. So I moved this ride and then I said, hey, can somebody come and refurbish it? And I've stopped recording one and then started recording this one. So nothing's changed. I haven't secretly built any rides or a pass, and I haven't secretly gone and taken all this lot out. Like I said, I was going to take it out, but I haven't taken it out. So here we go. So can we just move you? No. Can we close it and then move it? No. Okay. Do I need to do that? Nah. Yep. Yeah, we need to do that, and then we need to click move. And you are going to come up here because people tend to feel a bit ill when they come off this ride. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop it right next to the ride. And we can maybe put a bench in as well, so that people, when they come off, some of them might want to sit while their friend goes in there. And And look, the bins are full. Bins are full around here. People, where are my janitors? There's one coming now. He's coming now. So, yeah. Do we maybe get one more janitor? I think we do. Let's get one more janitor. Why have you gone orange? I've literally... Is it because everybody else has been trained and you haven't? Okay, well, we'll make sure that you're happy. Let's get another janitor. Four is a good number, isn't it? And this is old Jim. I've no idea what he's called, actually. So, he's actually called... he's actually called Emptying Bin. Oh, Lon, he's called. Lon Hagar. Hey, my name's Lon. I've come over from America. Lon's not a very... it's not a very English name. Lon. I mean, I've heard of the actor Lon Chaney, but again, you know, not English. So, it's not a very well-known name in England. Which is where I'm from. So if you're in any doubt whatsoever, yes, here I am recording in sunny England. And actually it is sunny today. From where I am, I can see out of the window. And we can see that the sun is shining. And the sky is really popular, isn't it? Can I get it in and get another ride in somewhere? Yeah, I can maybe get a smaller one in there. Where do we go to, my lovely? So we need to put an entrance in. I don't know why I was singing Peter Sarsstedt there, but there you go. A bit of Peter. So yeah, I'm in sunny England, and it is sunny today. It's beautiful. It's blue sky. It's crisp and cold. I'm actually recording this in December. I don't know what date it is. It's about December the 20th, something like that, or there or thereabouts. We're getting very close to Christmas. My Christmas tree is up, and there are presents under the Christmas tree, and there's not many for me, actually, which is a bit of a shame. Although I've been treating myself. I've had a few games. I bought myself a few. So, you know, if you are interested in anything along the lines of... what have I bought? Civilization 6, which would be a really long series. What else have I bought? I bought the... Battlefield 1. Now, that might turn up in my video feed at some point. So if you're interested at all in Battlefield 1, then that might be something that, if you put it in the comments, I can pop some Battlefield 1 footage in. That'd be good. What else have I bought? I bought Lara Croft Rise of the Tomb Raider, and I enjoyed that. It was quite a short game. I finished it already. Quite a short game, but really enjoyable. Really enjoyable. It's been a long, long time since I played any sort of Tomb Raider game, but that one really did hit the spot. And it sort of reminded me of the old Tomb Raider games, the very early ones. Not quite as much puzzling as I would have liked, where, you know, you've got a big room and you're trying to work out how to get to the top. It sort of leads you by the hand quite a lot, which is okay, I suppose. I need some shops up here, don't I? We need some shops. And what we're going to do is going to build a new... Let's build a new type of shop. Chief Beef. Ice cream. I haven't got a high screen. Oh, I haven't got a pizza hut, or anything like that. So what we're going to do is we're going to pop a pizza in there, and then what we're going to also do is we're going to get a drinky, gulpy soda, gulpy energy, cosmic cow. Let's go for cosmic cow. Can I do? Let's get these down here. Whoa, get you down, and then maybe at a building. It doesn't let you just turn it. Oh, it's a pain in the bottom. Right, we've got a drink. We've got a food and a drink. We're gonna need a lose, aren't we? We're gonna need a lose. Now, what do I do with this? Yeah, we'll put it there and hope that it doesn't put you the smell off, put you off your hot dog, maybe, like that. And then maybe we get an ATM in. That's not an ATM, that's an ATM. Don't like that. It says obstructed. Do I want to put it there? I don't want to put it there. In fact, what I'm going to do is we're going to put an information stall in and a gift shop. We're putting information stalls in so that people can buy these tickets for the priority pass tickets. And we definitely want a gift shop in. These things seem to be quite popular. And then ATM. Let's click the ATM before you do that. Like that. I'm gonna pop it in here. Don't want to go there. It does go there though. There we go. We've got a little cluster of buildings here. So let's just make these look like they are part of a building thing. And we want like a nice clean thing on here, I think. This music's a bit loud. Right. Okay. And what is? Gingerbread. Do we want to build a gingerbread style? I don't think so. So the gingerbread's there because the people who make Planet Coaster have released a Christmas version of it. So you can get all your Christmassy type things are all in there. Well, they're not all in there actually, and I have got a few issues with the Christmas thingy. In that, one of my requirements for these sort of games is, can I build like a Blackpool Pleasure Beach? Okay, so I am from England, and we have a fantastic theme park in England called Blackpool Pleasure Beach. I mean, there are others. Don't get me wrong. You know, there's sort of Alton Towers and Chessington World of Adventure, and there's loads. However, I think Blackpool is probably the biggest and most popular theme park thing in Britain. You know, I could go on and mention some others, like Thorpe Park and Lightwater Valley. That's quite a smallish one, but it has the one of the longest roller coasters in Britain. It's a hybrid, I think. Anyway, the point I'm making is... What is the point I'm making? Am I making a point? Is anybody saying anything? The point I'm making is... I would like to have a recreation of Blackpool Pleasure Beach because it's one of my favourite places to go to. I do love Blackpool Pleasure Beach. I love roller coasters. I absolutely love wooden roller coasters. And I'd like to make a recreation of Blackpool. But... there are rides at Blackpool that I cannot make using Planet Coaster, and that is an issue for me. So, for example, There's no log flume anymore, but what there is instead of a log flume is a couple of indoor water rides. So we have one of the best in the world, which is Valhalla, which consistently gets voted one of the best rides in the world. And it's... it's not something that I can make in Planet Coaster. Because they just don't have that sort of ride. There's another one at Blackpool called Avalanche, which is a toboggan type ride. And I can't build that either. And it's a little disappointing, really, that I can't live my dream of building Blackpool Pleasure Beach. So there's a few others that aren't represented in game, and it's a real shame. But there you go. I'm stuck with what I've got. So, and what I have got is pretty good. I need to hide that corner, don't I? Anyway, here I am building shops, and what I'm supposed to be doing is building rides. So let's... I've built a nice little shop complex, and we need rides, really. So let's just need to pop some benches in so that people can actually eat their burgers in peace, and then get back on the rides. And rides we need to build. Why is the background not readied out if I can't build it? Because it's like 2.6, but I can't afford that. It's 5,000. So, which one of these is the smallest? It's not the Sky Ace. Anyway, this one's the smaller, but it's still not going to fit in there, is it? And we've already got a Roctopus near here anyway. And I could put it somewhere else. Couldn't I? Can't fit it in there, and there's a Roctopus there anyway. But what about here? What about round here somewhere, or around the back of there? You are going in there, mate. You're going in there. That's it. Entrance is going to come from that side. Exit is going to go here. Yeah, the path straight down. We like that. Connect entrance to path. So yeah. So if I can't build Blackpool, which is a shame. You know, it tells me that there's things that the game's lacking. All right, now you might say, well, they've done a good job with this game, and I am not disagreeing with that. This game is fantastic. I really enjoy playing it, and it looks good, and the tools that are there are amazing. You can build some amazing parks and make them look fantastic as well. However. I could build Blackpool with, let's say, for example, Roller Coaster 2, Planet, blah, 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 whatever it was called. Roller Coaster Tycoon 2, something like that. And I could also say, right, all this area here is going to be my winter wonderland. Let's colour it in white so it looks like it's got snow on the ground. And you could do that. And there were other rides. So there's a ride at Blackpool called the Steeplechase, which is a horse ride where you sit on the horses and go around a track. Can't build that. There's no maze, which again you could do in an earlier roller coaster building game. You know, the point I'm making is even though this is brilliant, there's a lot that could be added yet to make it as good as possibly can be. Now, I know that they've not really focused on water riders as well, but I think there's a... I think certainly theming-wise, there's a bit they could do on that, although I have seen some fantastic water rides that people have made. Right, what do I need to do now? Because I've now built this, all right? We've got some shops here, we've got an ATM. Why did I not see that before when I was looking for tiny rides? Can we fit this in here at all? I think it won't go in because of this ride. I think because it spins round and comes over here, it doesn't like any rides underneath it. So I'm going to leave that for now. I could probably get it in here if I raised it up. I might need to raise it up quite a lot. I don't think I like that. Yeah, so I'm going to leave that. I'm going to not put that in. Although, whoa. Hold the press. Can we get... We might need to move a path. But we can move a path to get a ride in, can't we? Of course we can. Of course we can. We can do whatever you like. And don't forget now, I've got this big space to put a new ride in. And I've got the space down at the other end to put a new ride in. Oh, what happened with the forge number 2? Did it open? Yeah, it's open. So it got refurbished and then opened straight away. Right, so let's move this path. It's a bit of a funny thing there, isn't it? I don't quite like that. I might need to move that. Might need to just adjust it. But the reason we've moved it is so we can pop one of these in. Ain't it? So let's have an entrance, yeah, and let's have an exit, yeah. Entrance. There we go. Now, I don't think we need a priority queue on this, do we? It's a little kiddies ride. It's not going to be massively popular. Beautiful. That's the way. We've got kiddies going on it already. I don't like this path. Can we sort the path out, please? That's done something weird there, hasn't it? Look at that. What's that all about? Sorry, folks. No, this is definitely weird. I don't like it. It's not playing nice. I don't like that. Thank you. Okay, there we go. More rides. Got more rides in. And hopefully this is dragging people up here and getting them on this fella. Screaminator's broke down. Oh, big Screaminator's broke down. Oh, that's a shame. What else is going on? Insanity. Insanity. Screaminator. Blah, blah, blah. Screaminator. Broken down. Right, somebody will be on the way. Don't worry about it. Now, how are we doing up here? They're still a bit empty, aren't they, these rides up here? We've got stalls and things, haven't we? We've got stuff going on. We could do with building some more rides in here. Couldn't we? So what have we not got up here? We've not got a 360 power, have we? Well, there's one there. Okay, we have got one. We haven't got a Roctopus. So a Roctopus somewhere would go nicely, wouldn't it? And well, actually, let me put it in here. But again, if I pop it in there, there's no other rides I can put in around it, you know? I can probably get one here. And maybe a bigger ride in the middle, is what I'm thinking. I don't like them floating up in the air like that. I can disguise it, though. Can't we? We can disguise how high up it is. Place entrance. Where do we want the entrance on this? There, and the exit. Oh, look at that. Straight down. So you can go up on your wheelchair. And then when you go on the ride, and it's fantastic, and you enjoy it, and then you can't get off because you're coming downstairs. Roctopus. Float. There we go. And let's now disguise it a little bit. Let's have some large rocks and stuff. Right, I think what we need to do with this is align to surface, because it automatically then moves the rocks around and stuff. We don't want angle snap on, do we? This ride open? There's nobody going on it. Looks a bit better. Looks a little bit better. Okay, needs a bit of work. And we need some greenery on it as well, don't we? Definitely needs greenery. I have a floating plant there, never mind. I don't want prickly pear. We don't want ironwood, we don't want creosote bushes. Bit better, you know, and the scenery on this now will have a better rating. Look, 7%. Why? Well, it's only that bit that I've done, that's why. It's all around the front. Okay, well, it looks a little bit better. It needs work, it needs more work, but I'm not here to do that, am I? I'm here to try and get people on the rides. That's what we need. We need people on these rides. Can I get one of these fellas in again? Because this. No, it's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. How about something like that? Now, I can't afford it, but it certainly fits in, doesn't it? It certainly fits in. The thing is, there's more land I could use. I could build up above this. And I've got this up here, and I've got this down here. We've got options here. Okay, we have got options. I just don't know what I want to build anywhere else. We've got limited ride designs available now, haven't we? Okay, right. So let's just leave the rides for now. And let's just have a quick look and see where we're up to with all this. Because, you know, we've been building stuff and I haven't really been paying attention to what's going on down here. So what have we got here now? Rides and tickets. Rides and tickets. It's saying that we're getting around 2,000. Okay, which, it's not a great amount, is it? It's not a great amount. So we need to encourage people onto these. We need to encourage them onto these up this end as well, because these are the ones that are getting underused. And if I look at my park management on here, attractions and shops, look, there's rides here that are getting minuses. Minuses, look. Minuses. I mean, that's the new Rocktopus. I've only just built that. But there's stuff around here. Rocktopus 3. Why are you not getting loads and loads and loads of people on? And it says the queue's quick. Queue looks fast. People are getting on and off. I'm just not getting the footfall. See, maybe we need another ride in here. Maybe this is where we need to put another ride. Isn't it? Hey? Isn't it? Isn't that where that goes? Doesn't that look like it lives in there? Does to me. Boo boo doo boo doo boo boo doo boo doo boo doo doo. Right, so there you go. Right, we're going to leave it there for now. We've now got a theme park with loads and loads of rides. There's loads of rides. Look, they're everywhere. Everywhere you look, loads of rides. I think what we need to do is we need to start focusing on the ones that aren't making the money. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let the thing run for a little while and we'll find out, because I've built a lot in a short space of time. I built this and this and some down here and the Rocktopus, and we just need time for people to get into the park and get to these rides at the back. And the other thing we're going to do is we're going to go into marketing. So I've never done any marketing, so let's do marketing. So what have we got? Poster campaign. Who reads posters anymore? There's a lot of vomit in the park apparently. TV commercials, they'll be fine. Online campaigns as well. banner adverts, Gulpy videos, viral videos, attracts more teens but fewer adults. Well, who's in my park anyway? I stepped in sick. Balloons is busy. There's litter. Guys, we need more staff. Guys, we need a couple more of these. Let's just get two of these fellas popped in. There we go. Two more cleaners just to help with that. Right, let's get back to park management. So what else is going on? Well, overview. Right, well, I'm sorting that out. All right, so who's in the park? Guest summary. We've got... It's mainly teen groups, isn't it? And there are some adult groups. So why don't we advertise for adult groups? It's very close between those two. So let's get maybe teens and adult groups. Okay, so let's go for a start marketing campaign, and we'll go for a viral video. More teens. Okay, so that'll auto renew. Do we do that? All right, and we're going to do one on the TV. Teenagers, lots of families. Adult groups, there we go. So we should have both sets of groups. I've got an achievement, hurrah! Coming into the park. And what I'm going to do is, in the next video, we'll find out what that impact is. And, you know, by that time, we'll have lots and lots of people coming up here, and they'll be doing all the right things and spending all their money. Come on, Robert, you've just robbed Spears. No idea. You're not telling me I've got no staff. What's that? Look, mechanics, no. Right, I've got some of those. No vendors at all. There's no vendors. What's all that about? I have no vendors and no mechanics. I don't think that's the case, is it? I quite clearly have vendors. A vendor's quit. Just a memento. What? No. Right. So, are you gonna tell me what I've got in now? Oh, I've got two now. Ah, yeah, there we go. Look, we can do something with this now. Now we've seen how many people we've got. So let's do that. Three clicks for you. Get you trained again. 1, 2, 3. It's because you've got nobody coming to you. And then we've got 1, 2, 3 there. Bang. I can't train these two yet because you're brand new. Mechanics are good. Normal workload. Good. Right. As I said, I'm going to leave it there. Next month, or next video, next month. We're going to be trying to maximise the rides that aren't doing so well. And I don't quite know how to do that. I don't know whether we change the way they're set up so that they don't need a full load and they go a bit sooner, so they go after a minute or something. That might be a good option. So the rides are going more frequently with less people on, so we're not waiting for 2 minutes to get 20 people on. We're actually going after a minute with 20 people on, and we'll see. Well, we need to have a look at it, and yeah, we're gonna try and get that thing sorted here. We need to get this sorted. So it's gone up from the 2,000 that it had when I first started this video to 3,700, but that looks like a big goal now. So hopefully advertising campaign will work as well, and that'll bring millions of people in, and we're going to have throngs. There'll be thronging. Should be people thronging in. Great. So I hope you enjoy it. Give me a thumbs up, thumbs down. Leave comments in the comments. Please subscribe if you like the channel. If you don't like the channel, please don't subscribe. No, you can subscribe anyway, even if you don't like the channel. And if you do like it, thank you very much for subscribing. And I do appreciate the subscribers. I'll see you next time. My name's Bat Blast. See you later.